Hello, my dear students. So in this video lecture, I am going to discuss about circulatory system. What is circulatory system? The system which help in the process of circulation. Okay. So for the circulatory system, we have one major organ which is known as heart and which is known as pumping organ. And what it will pump? It will pump the blood. Okay. This is the pumping organ. And second thing is blood vessels. This blood is going to pump through blood vessels. And what are the blood vessels? These may be arteries, veins or capillaries. Okay. Blood vessels may be arteries, veins or capillaries. So, veins or capillaries. And third thing is about what is going to pump? That is the blood. Third one is blood. And what is blood? This is a fluid connective tissue. So, these three points, we have to discuss about these all three points in the circulatory system. What exactly is blood? So, what is blood? So, this is a fluid connective tissue. This is a fluid connective tissue. So, in this video lecture, I am going to discuss about the introductory part of the blood. What is blood and what are the functions of the blood? Okay, so this is a fluid connective tissue. And the special quality of blood is it never stationary. It will never be stationary. So blood is always in motion, it is always in motion from heart to the arteries and back through the veins. And this is in motion from heart to arteries, Okay. And second thing I want to discuss about blood is the color. What is the color of blood? The color of blood is red due to the presence of hemoglobin. Color is red due to the presence of a special protein which is called as hemoglobin. And along with this hemoglobin, oxygen is bind and it will form oxyhemoglobin. When hemoglobin it bind with the oxygen, it will form oxyhemoglobin, that is HbO2. And how much blood is present in the human body or in adult human body according to the volume? That is 5 to 6 liter of blood is present in the adult human body. Okay. And the taste of the blood is saltish. That is saltish in taste. Okay. So, now we will discuss about the functions of blood. What functions of the blood are actually present? So, this blood, it will perform some functions like first one is, it will help in the transportation of digested food. Transportation of digested food from the alimentary canal to the tissues. Digested food from where to where? From alimentary canal to tissues. And second thing is, it help in the transportation of oxygen. Because this blood is containing hemoglobin and this hemoglobin bind with the oxygen to form oxyhemoglobin. So, transportation of oxygen from where to where? From lungs to the tissues. It will transport oxygen from lungs to the tissues. And if I want to discuss about the third point, that is the transportation of CO2. It will help in the transportation of CO2. That is CO2, that is carbon dioxide. And when hemoglobin binds with the carbon dioxide, it will form carbaminohemoglobin. And fourth thing is, it helps in the transportation of excretory material. And last but not the least, it is also helpful in the distribution of hormones. And also helpful for the distribution of heat. Okay. So this blood, it is similar to the lymph, but lymph, it is blood and lymph. So, what is lymph? How it is different from the blood? This lymph, it is containing WBC only, and this blood, if I talk about the components of blood, so this blood will contain RBC, WBC and platelets. These three are the parts or blood cells which are taking part in the formation of different processes of the circulatory system. So what is RBC? They are also known as erythrocytes, and WBC are known as leukocytes, and platelets are known as thrombocytes. So these all are the blood cells. Along with these blood cells, plasma is also present in the blood. Okay. So this is all about the components of the blood. So this video lecture is totally about the introductory part of the circulatory system, and a brief idea I have given for the blood. So this is all about this lecture. Thank you, my dear students. Thank you.